¿Estamos listos?
Woody, we have a situation.
I am not a toy. I was made for soup, salad, maybe chili, and then the trash.
I was just thinking that you guys, the crew, Josh, you're sort of like Bonnie. Because you are the heirs to the legacy of these beloved toys.
Oh, yeah.
What it was like for you when someone comes and tells you, do you want to direct Toy Story 4 as your first feature film?
It's a huge honor, first of all, but it's very terrifying at the same time. As you can imagine, there's so much love for these characters and just not only out in the world, but internally at Pixar, they're so kind of sacred to us and special. And so it was a huge, huge honor. But at the same time, there was a lot of nights when I didn't sleep very well.
It's also the return of Bo, mm-hmm. which was sort of who was sort of an unfinished business. What was your vision for her? And if you can talk a little bit about her evolution from the first film to this film.
Yeah, we love Bo Peep, and we talked a lot about the fact that she was always this anchor kind of for Woody. I mean, they've always had this great relationship. They obviously adore each other, but she was absent, I think, kind of used dramatically to show in the third movie that there are stakes, there is danger in this world. You know, you don't always end up back in your kid's bedroom. And so we thought the question about where she went was a really big question for us, and we thought, well, for Woody especially, like what he sort of missed out, and we had this opportunity to bring her back in a way that could really be impactful to him and to the audience. We've always loved her. Even the fact that she's a lamp, we've even debated in the story room, like, is she a toy? Like, she has this sort of built-in identity crisis, and we played into that. Like, she is a toy, and she is who she is, and she kind of comes back in with a little more purpose, a little more punch to her than we would expect.
And she was always, from day one, was always the kind of the genesis of Toy Story 4. We even, our code name for the movie internally was Peep. So it was always about her and figuring out how she can come back in and really affect Woody's world.
So to speak, one of the main motors that drove Pixar to do Toy Story 4?
Yeah, I'd say the main motor, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but I was looking at my relationship with my wife and seeing how how when the two of us came together, and she kind of, sounds cheesy, but opened my eyes to new things, and so that was kind of the inspiration that I was pulling from personally to kind of see, like, they've had this relationship, and now that she's back, he's going to listen to her because he knows her so well. If it was just some stranger, it wouldn't really matter, but because it's so previous established relationship, it means something.
Woody, who needs a kid's room when you can have all of this?
Wow. Woody, aren't we going to Bonnie?
In the creative process, did you embrace change as well? I mean, because this is a franchise with so much past.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
How do you embody that concept in the creative process?
We talked about it constantly, right? Even from the way that we'd shoot the film and the way we wanted it to sound.
That's right. Yeah, even the aspect ratio of the film is wide, super widescreen 2:3:9 versus the 1:8:7 of the previous films. We did that on purpose to make sure that it felt different but still within the same world. What else? The music we talked about?
Yeah, we looked at the whole thing and we just said, we want to make this our version of, like, it's Toy Story. We want to honor the sort of the nostalgia and the ingredients that make a Toy Story film, but in our own way. And so we shot it a little bit differently. I think we're a little closer to the characters. We're up close to their faces, the textures.
The depth of field is different.
The depth of field, the tight focus. We just tried to shift it just a bit, not so that it's unrecognizable, but just so that it has its own identity. And so from the art department to the lighting department rendering, everything was about what's our version of it. We want it to feel unique.
And that's the hardest thing is you want a sequel, you want to make a film that people know this world, know these characters, but if you make the exact same movie again, it doesn't work. And so there's this really, really fine line.
Pixar also is so well known for the research it does for movies.
Yeah.
What type of research did you do for these new locations, which are really new to the franchise, like the antique shop, for example, which is amazing?
Well, we just dug around. In California, there's lots of antique shops and antique stores like that. And so we sent our crew, art department, the sets department, camera department to those stops and just
shot photos and crawled behind cabinets.
Yeah, we took cameras and put them on selfie sticks and just ran them along the ground just to see what it would look like from a toy's point of view. And that's where we saw a lot of really interesting things, like electrical strips with all the cords plugged in. There's like a lot of fire hazards all over the place behind cabinets and spider webs and dust and stuff that you would never notice from our point of view, but from a toy's point of view, it's completely different.
Everything's gonna be okay.